Oh, that's got to be... I thought I discovered a comet, but I'm realizing I think that's a reflection inside the focal reducer. Because it does not show any... comets in the field of view. See if I can go over to Hines Variable Nebula.
Telescopes luing to target. Telescopes lu complete.
See if we got Hines Variable Nebula. Well, if that's it, that's...
Operation completed.
That could be it. Why? I doubt it. Let me go back to something a little bit easier to...
Telescopes luing to target. Telescopes lu complete.
See if we get the dome or if I gotta go move it. Night, Steve. Glad you could join in. California Nebula without the power line. I'm going to go to a longer exposure for it. See what happens with 25. If it's too much or... seconds may be too much. Let's see what happens with the live stack. It's too low. It's 50 degrees up at azimuth 68, so that's pretty high up. It's away from the power line now. Tomorrow night, if it's clear, I may try throwing a filter in just to see what happens. So far, I've captured 326 images over the last 2.5 hours. Be interesting to see. What happens when I try processing? Some of them are tweaking them. It's all too low, too low. It's probably going to be too low to look at right now. There's a comet passing right by Orion. It's 20 degrees up. Let me see if that clears the...
Telescope's flew into target.
The trees to the east.
Maybe not.
Telescope slew complete.
I don't think so. I think I got the tree nebula. Yep, I don't think that's gonna work. Let me reduce the exposure. Let's try 15 seconds, see what happens. I don't think Orion's cleared the trees yet. Well, there's... Well, maybe that is the comet. Son of a gun. Let me do a white balance. The comet's moving away from the tree. Let me try a shorter exposure. 10 seconds. Yeah, that's Comet Atlas. Comet, okay, let me put that designation in. Smaller than that. And a satellite right above it. M42 is behind the tree. See, this comet is 22 degrees up, and it's about 7 degrees lower. So if we wait 30 minutes, we maybe will get the M42. But yeah, that's the comet there. You can see the tree gradually moving away. There's a row of trees on my neighbor's property about 200 feet to the east of the observatory. And that's the top of the trees you're seeing there. See, there's the comet right there. So if I live stack this, I'm not tracking on the comet. From what I remembered looking at in SkyTools, this comet's moving pretty fast from south to north, right along the side of Orion. Doing. God, her sugars are just comet's supposed to be magnitude 7.52. The coma's a 7.52. Trying to look at SkyTools to get a hint. SkyTools, I think, shows the tail. SkyTools shows the tail kind of pointing in this direction. To say it's a little diffuse like that. definitely moved away from the tree. See if Orion's clearing the trees yet. Let's see, how low can I go?
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
This is probably going to be the tree nebula. Yep. I'm aimed at Alnitak right now. Have to see how long it's going to take for the flame in the horse head to move out. It's an interesting view. Yeah, the tail is pointed up to the, I guess, the west of the belt stars. I think that's the one of the belt stars behind the tree, and another belt star coming out from the tree. Generally don't look this low in the sky. the star in the center is the one, Alnitak, that has to have the flame and the horse head by it. In fact, I think I see the flame. Ready. How high is this? 19 degrees altitude. Yep, flame is just to the right of Alnitak. It's gradually rising out of the tree. That's just an interesting composition. I did the solar eclipse in 2017 from just north of Nashville, and I had the same thing. I had two MallinCams going on two different scopes, recording a frame every, I guess it was every minute, and then I stitched them together to make time lapses, one in white light and one in H alpha. Just shows you how low this is in the sky. And now I know that that tree line is about 20 degrees tall to the east of me. Okay, there's That's 2023, right in that little notch in the trees, that little dot, there's a, that's that blue reflection nebula. And the Horsehead should be coming into view shortly. Follow the curve from the center of the flame over to 2023, and you continue on to the Horsehead. So the Horsehead should be somewhere over here. It's not very the Horsehead is right here. Do some live stack and see if it cleans it up any. My exposure time is what, 10 seconds? You can see the Horsehead now. It's not very clear because of the low altitude. Clearly there. Not bad for 10 seconds and at low altitude. I ought to do another white balance. Probably as low as it is, white balance is really screwed up. Sent me stopped the stack and started again, seeing as the tree is moving out of the field. Yeah. Well, I'm recording this. I got 38 minutes into this recording. But you can just show them how fast the Earth rotates. It's 10 second exposure, and I'll stop the stacking. I got the black level almost buried in the curve. As low as it is. See, now you can see the watch the tree move away. Every 10 seconds, another shift. I don't know if Orion is high enough yet.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
I'm hitting the dome, I guess. Maybe it's too low. Oh, it was hitting the side of the shutter. Okay. Shutter's out the way. Might have a power line in the way now, though. I mean, this is how low. This is 20 degrees up. I think this is going to be my last target for tonight. Yeah, you got the Running Man and the Orion Nebula. Easily. I went to 5 seconds. Oh, look at all the satellites right below the Running Man. There's three of them, and there's three of them to the right of the Running Man. See them? That's not bad for as low as it is. Good night, Bernie. Well, everybody, I am also signing off. It's been fun testing out the new field flat or focal reducer for this scope. Glad you could stop by and join me. And it's supposed to be clear tomorrow night. If so, I will be back out trying this all over again. Y'all have a good evening and good night for now.